sunrise in the Everglades. 1.5 million acres of tropical wetlands unlike any other in the world. Hundreds of animal species call this area home, including dozens considered rare, endangered, or exotic. But an unwanted guest is literally eating its way through the ecosystem at an alarming rate. Burmese pythons, natives of Southeast Asia, routinely grow 12 to 15 feet or larger in length. And the National Park Service estimates there are more than 100,000 of them in the Everglades. Auburn University research professor David Steen is a leading expert studying invasive and non-native wildlife populations.
Invasive species are probably one of the biggest threats to the conservation of biodiversity today. And a lot of people don't really realize that, let alone the different species that are particularly damaging. And Burmese pythons are a problem in South Florida. And so anything I can do to help raise awareness of that problem, I'm glad to do it.
Steen is part of a four-man team competing in the 2016 Python Challenge, a program sponsored by Florida's Fish and Wildlife Conservation Commission aimed at eradicating the snakes and bringing attention to their impact. The idea is to find the biggest or the most. Steen's team has strong Auburn ties. Stephen Neslidge is a senior producer for the Weather Channel and a 2005 Auburn graduate.
This is a role reversal for me. I'm typically the one doing the interviews and gathering the footage, so to actually be involved in doing something was a really nice change of pace. But to come to one of the most treacherous landscapes in America, hunt an apex predator, and then take it alive is a rush. That's pretty incredible.
The pythons are prolific breeders, and their numbers in the Everglades grow exponentially every year. Even so, they're nearly impossible to find because of their ability to blend in. A similar program in 2013 drew 1,600 participants, but teams only found 68 snakes.
They have elite level camouflage. You can walk over a snake and not see it. Once you actually see one laying in the grass, you understand why they're so hard to find.
After hours of searching the Southern Glades Wildlife and Environmental Area, Sean Sterrett put the team on the board with the capture of a large snake near a canal.
You know, we'd spent days talking to each other about what do you think you would do if you see one? Are you going to be brave enough to do it? And he proved himself brave enough, and he took it on. But it was a large python. It was about 10 feet long, and he was all by himself, and he had only one bag with him at the time. So he started calling everybody. Pretty bad reception out here in the middle of nowhere, so it went to voicemail. We all kind of realized at the same time that we had all these messages like, hey, I've got a big one here. I might need a bigger bag, so give me a hand. So what we did was we ended up running towards where we knew he was, and soon we saw him kind of wobbling on his bike coming towards us, and there was a large snake in a bag weighing down the handlebars. So I didn't know he was that skilled on the bike in a dirt road, balancing a 10-foot, 30-pound python, but I was impressed. And he was right. It was a large, impressive animal. And so when we got a look at it, it was we gave him a lot of congratulations for taking it on all by himself.
Partnerships such as those with Auburn University, the University of Florida, and some of our other research partners has definitely helped us gain not just additional information about Burmese pythons or other invasive species, but help us raise awareness and bring that information to a broader audience.
The snakes captured this year will not even dent their population, but news coverage nationwide and significant social media discussion have brought the issue front and center. Steen says for him, the hands-on experience will pay off big as he interacts with Auburn students down the road.
I think it really grabs people's attention when you can tell them a story about catching a python with your own hands or what you have to do to find them and how many are out there. If you have that first-hand knowledge, I think it resonates a lot more with students. And it's kind of a personal connection with the issue rather than just a series of facts.